You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where Gary shows us how to make things that sometimes don't work with the bot framework easily work really quickly. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're going to learn a little bit more about bots, maybe some fundamentals and some surprises. Gary, why don't you introduce yourself?
Yeah, so I'm Gary Pretty. I'm a senior engineer on the Bot Framework SDK team.
So let's start with bots and channels. I've heard that a lot. Why don't you describe what that is?
Yeah, so you build a bot. Your bot is essentially, it's a web application, okay? But you want to surface that in multiple places. Okay. So let's say you wanted to put a bot into Facebook Messenger or web chat, or at Microsoft Teams, for example. They are channels. So you can think of channels almost like where you surface your bot. Where can I talk to my bot? Whether that's through voice or through text, that's a channel. And a channel is specific to what's called the Azure Bot Service. Okay. And what we can see here is in Azure, I've created a bot. And it's as simple as take a look at the channels list. Right now, I've connected my bot to Microsoft Teams and to web chat. But then down here, I've got a list of additional channels. So I could, if I wanted to, put it in Slack or in Skype, Facebook. I could connect it up to Office 365 email. It's a pretty extensive list.
And it's the same backend that is able to communicate with all of these things.
Yeah, that's right. So there's something called the Bot Framework Adapter, which sits within the SDK and will receive messages from the Azure Bot Service. And it's the responsibility of the Azure Bot Service to take the incoming request from, say, Facebook or Microsoft Teams, and then to translate that into this common format that we understand within our bots.
I see.
Yeah.
So as I'm looking at this list, what if there's something there that I want, but that's not there? Is there a way to make it still work?
Yeah, so with the version 4 of the SDK, we have something called custom adapters. So I mentioned before the bot framework adapter in the SDK. Well, we can actually go and implement the adapter interface and write our own adapter if we want to. And the responsibility of that custom adapter is really pretty simple. It takes a request from a platform, whichever platform you want to support. It will transform that into bot activities. The bot will handle them in the same way as it would do. The same code will handle that, if you were running in Teams. And then it will send that back, and the adapter will then transform it back into a response that's appropriate for that channel.
So it's basically like an intermediary between what the bot framework understands and then whatever else, right. Any other thing. It could be like an IoT device with a terminal or something.
Yeah, exactly.
That's cool. Well, can you show us how that works?
Yeah, sure. So I've got a fairly basic bot here running in the emulator, which I've had a brief conversation with. So it's a flight booking bot. And I've said, it said, where do you want to travel to? London, I'm coming from Seattle. So what I'm showing here is we have an endpoint /API/messages, and that's where the emulator will actually send the messages to. That's going to be handled by the built-in bot framework adapter. The bot's going to process that message and then send the response back via that bot framework adapter. So if we switch over to Visual Studio, what we can see here is the adapter with error handler is our instance of the standard bot framework adapter. And we also have a controller, our bot controller. And this is the API messages endpoint. And the responsibility of this controller is simply to say, I'm going to hand off to that bot framework adapter. And I'm going to say, here's the request that's come in. And now send that to my bot. And then when the request comes back, then it's going to post that back to whichever channel that I'm working with.
Totally makes sense. Okay. So the couple of questions. So the adapter's job is to transform the messages back and forth so the bot framework can understand it. Now, do I have to, like, for example, if I want this to work with other channels, do I have to have multiple adapters, or how does that work?
Yeah, so you would have an adapter if the, let's say there's a channel that you would like to use and it's not available on Azure Bot Service yet, or for maybe security or compliance reasons, there's a reason you can't use Azure Bot Service. Mm-hmm. We have custom adapters built into the SDK, mm-hmm. and we also have adapters which have been contributed to our Bot Builder community project on GitHub. So we've got adapters for Twilio, WebEx, WeChat. So there are some, fairly common requirements that people were asking us, can I connect my bot to WeChat? So we've gone ahead and built a WeChat adapter and made that available. And you would have typically an adapter per platform that you want to support that's not within the Azure Bot Service. And to implement that is really, really straightforward. So first thing you do is you go and find the NuGet package from NuGet for the adapter that you want to use. So the top three that you can see here are Alexa, Google, and Twitter, which mm-hmm. are our community adapters, you know, maintained by the community, but also supported by the SDK team as well, in terms of we contribute to them all the time. And then we've got the built-in adapters, Twilio and WebEx. We've also got adapters for Slack and Facebook, which actually have a slightly larger footprint for those two particular platforms. Once you've installed the particular package, so I've installed the Alexa adapter in this case, so I want to have my bot be able to power an Alexa skill.
Mm-hmm.
But the great thing is, because I can just add an additional controller, like I have done here, I've added an Alexa controller, it adds an additional endpoint. So I can still have the conversation from the emulator or through Teams or Facebook. I don't lose anything, but I actually add this additional endpoint for, in this case, Alexa. And I've got an Alexa adapter with error handler class, which is just the Alexa adapter. And then we're adding some standard error handling in as well. So really quick, you can add this to an existing bot in just a few minutes. And then what will happen, I've got this bot running at the moment. So if I switch over to this is the Alexa developer console. And all I've had to do here is create an Alexa skill. I've registered an Alexa skill and I've pointed that Alexa skill, said your fulfillment URL is the new /API/Alexa endpoint. So now any request that comes from Alexa is going to hit that Alexa controller, which is going to hand it to the Alexa adapter. And then that will actually transform the JSON, in this case, it's being received from Alexa, send it to my bot in a format that it understands, that common format that mm-hmm. we're already very familiar with. And then when it comes back, it will transform it into an Alexa response and send that back to the service. And what that allows us to do is this. So I can say open flight booker. So just as you would say, you know, Echo open flight booker. And right now I've actually, I've got a quick tip for people is I'm using ngrok in this case to actually tunnel through to my local bot. So it's not like the debugging experience is awesome, because actually this Alexa simulator is actually calling through to my local bot. I can stick breakpoints in, I can understand what's happening.
That's cool.
And what you can see has happened here is we've got the JSON input, so I can see the full request that Alexa sent to my bot. And again, I could stick a breakpoint on the controller and actually see that coming in. And you can see the response that's being output by the bot. So I can then carry on having a multi-turn conversation with this. So I can say, book a flight. That's going to send a follow-up request. But because the bot framework will handle things like state management and it knows where you are in the conversation, you don't lose any of that. You retain all of that, you know, goodness within the SDK. You can see here that I'm actually able to have a multi-turn conversation with Alexa. If I wanted to, I could add in Google as well. It's almost like the Xamarin of Home Assistants in that case.
Cool.
Or I could just as easily be using one of the adapters within the SDK as well that we've made available. So I guess just to call out in terms of where you get started, we've got some fantastic docs in Microsoft Docs for things like WebEx, Twilio, etc. So these will actually just walk you through how you connect the adapter up. It's really no more complicated than what you just saw. Actually, the most time consuming bit is usually configuring the platform
right.
rather than configuring your bot. And then our bot builder community is, you know, it's an active community. We've got repos for all of our different SDKs. If I just jump into the .NET community, we have lots of different extensions for bot framework. But here are the three adapters that you could see, and we've got really good documentation on here as well in terms of how you can get started.
So a couple of questions. So I understand the notion of adapter. Like when I'm, and this, I did a bot a long time ago, and so maybe you can help refresh me. What I did is when I created a bot, I just selected the channels that it would work in, and it would just work.
Yes.
When it comes to these special adapters, it seems like I have to do some code stuff, which makes sense because you got to do transformations. But how does the bot know that it can, for example, because let's just say Teams is obviously one of the ones that's in there, I'm not going to do any coding for Teams, it will just work. And then for the adapter, I have to add code. How does it know to do both at the same time?
Right. So if we jump back to Visual Studio, the fact that we've got these two controllers, the controller is being set up for that particular platform. So if it comes in on API/messages, it's going to hand it to the built-in bot framework adapter. And if it comes in on the Alexa endpoint, it's going to hand it to the Alexa adapter. By the time that incoming request gets to my bot, where I'm actually, you know, processing that message, the incoming message looks exactly the same. So you can build this single application and send and receive messages. The adapter is going to handle all that complexity for you of transforming those requests in and out. We can then take advantage of additional platform features. So the Home Assistant adapters for Alexa and Google, for example, allow you to do things like take advantage of the screens on, say, the Echo Show or the Google Nest Hub. So you can show rich cards or videos. And all you would do in that case, that's exactly the same as when you're tailoring your conversation for other channels. You can say within your bot, if this message has come from Alexa, play this video via Alexa. Or if it's come from Google, send a push notification to the Android device. Or if it's come from Teams, I want to, you know, set a notification off for the user.
So let me see if I understand correctly. Mm-hmm. Basically, because you give it a route for that specific adapter, it comes in, and then the adapter does the translation, but then it passes it off to your standard bot logic that you've built for everything else.
Exactly.
Okay. Yeah. Which makes sense. It basically redirects and then makes the message exactly what we want, does the thing. Okay, that makes more sense, right? Because that was my confusion was like, where, how does this all happen? But now that you're doing the routing, that makes a lot more sense.
Yeah, because it routes it. And so in theory, what that means is you could build a conversation that is not in any way tailored to any specific channel or platform and literally just sends and receives messages, and you can have an identical conversation on all of them like you've just seen.
Right.
But then you could tailor on top of that and say, well, if I am running in this particular context of a Home Assistant device, then I'm gonna do something extra.
Got it.
Yeah.
And then you would know, because in the conversation it would be like where it came from.
Yes.
And it could be some switch statement or some code thing that you do.
Exactly.
That makes sense. Well, this is awesome. Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for watching. We'll be learning all about adapters, how you can get other things, channels that maybe are not available in the bot framework, to actually work just like as if they were. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time. Take care.